Hello and welcome back to Irish Football Fan TV. Today we are here in the Crumlin Boxing Club with Declan Geraghty. Ahead of his IBF international title fight, we also have Kieran McGregor from Heavy Bag Boxing. And we're just going to ask you a little bit, obviously ahead of your fight. You're fighting against John O'Carroll again. Are you looking for redemption?
Yeah, well, this is a rematch. I pick up the disqualification the first time around. So, trying to put things right. And hopefully, it'll be a different outcome, the result. At the end of the day, I was winning the fight the first time. Got disqualified with 20 seconds to go. Ahead on all scorecards. So, I'm still looking to be winning the fight, but hopefully I fucking get to the last round and pick up the win.
Yeah, well, obviously fans are excited to see it. We did get the fight of the year. So, it was hopefully go in there and get the win.
Hopefully be performance of the year this year instead of fight of the year.
That's
you know
it.
I mean? Performance makes it easier, you know what I mean?
Yeah. And how did you get into boxing originally?
My father was a coach, so I'm innocent, really nappies, to be honest with you. It's all I know. It's like writing with my left hand. Do you know what I mean? That's all I know is the box. So I've been doing it since I've been in nappies, and still to this day I'm still doing it, lucky enough.
Yeah, and when did you realise that you were good enough to go pro?
Fucking everyone's turning pro at this stage, you know what I mean? Never mind if they're good enough, everyone's turning pro at this stage. But in fairness, there's a handful of us, there is a good few of us turning pro, we've won so much as amateurs, like I've won every Irish title there is to win in Ireland. International, World Championship, European Championships, Olympic Test events, so it was always, if the money was right, it was always going to go, you know what I mean? So
yeah.
I ended up turning pro, but it's not about being good enough, because it's plenty of people who are at the tournament over who have done white collar shows, you know what I mean? Or no disrespect to any of them, but like that anyone kind of turn over pro now really. And the way Ireland is, I think there's had to be in, it's the most there's ever been pro. I think there's, I could be wrong, but I think there's
record. Like, I'd be a pro.
A few minutes we could have a little spray and see how it's feeling, you know what I mean?
You
know what I mean? But I think there's over 100 or 200 at the tournament pro in the last 2 years, you know what I mean? So at the moment, at the highest it's ever been, the numbers turning over, but so.
If Rio Ferdinand can turn pro, anyone can.
You know what I mean? I'm looking forward to seeing. Who's the cricket player who turned pro a while ago?
Flintoff, isn't
it?
You
know what I mean?
Yeah,
yeah. That cunt has been
Rio Ferdinand.
The end of, you know what I mean?
Rio Ferdinand.
Yeah, real.
He's probably McGuigan on his training as well.
Yeah, he had Shane McGuigan was training him. I don't know who's doing Rio this time. It's not McGuigan,
no.
I don't know who it is.
No, he was a WBC Cruiserweight champion, I think.
In fairness, I thought he turned pro because of, I remember seeing a documentary on BBC about the misses and all. I was thinking, it could have been down of, he needs to be doing something to keep himself active to keep his head off it.
Yeah.
But it was, he's remarried or something now, you know what I mean? So it's nothing to do with that.
That's
what Rachel told us, he's remarried. So I thought it was just a bit of aggression, take it out and be occupied doing coaching, you know what I mean?
Paying the bills
and
whatever.
And I said, sure, that one has plenty of money.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? But some people,
some
people are mad. Some people like getting punched in the face, you know what I mean? So the cunt's going to know about soon enough.
Because Betfair did something like that with Natalie before, where they got this woman who was, I think, Olympic swimmer, and they got her to become a jockey. So they came forward to him and said, we're going to documentary you.
Oh, I see.
Going to another sport, I think.
I'd say he probably had 2 or 3 fights and that's to be the end of it. Listen, anyone who's doing this sport knows when they're in there how hard it is.
Mm.
It's not messing about. Like, it's fucking hard at living.
Yeah.
Like, it's a real, like, you get, when anyone asks you what you do, like, get punched in the face and make a few quid. Like, that's technically what it is, you know what I mean? So,
and then obviously there's the weight cut, which you're obviously going to talk about. So there's there's a lot of dedication that goes into it. Like, you wouldn't find yourself out on a Friday as much as you used to, or anything like that, you know?
You have to call the early nights early, you know what I mean? There's no fucking late nights anymore.
Yeah. You said in the past, like, how there's many times when you're boxing you thought about kind of like walking away from it, do you know what I mean? At the start, because obviously, would you say there has to be more support for the fighters only coming up? Because obviously when you're starting, obviously you're fighting every 7 weeks, but your pay is like, you're getting half of the money, but then you have to pay your trainer, you pay your taxes and all that crap. Do you think there has to be more support, a bit like almost in line with the UFC kind of with upper
comfort? I just think it's hard full stop for anyone to break through. There's only a handful of people who can break through. It's the reason why I've ever thought about going away is because before I turned pro, as an amateur set up, it's very corrupt. It can be, there's times where I've been seen a champion, I should be going to the world championships, and one fellow boxed before in the seniors, I broke my hand the first 20 seconds of the fight. and I beat him by 13, 14 points after, like another 7 minutes of boxing for, I'm beating by 14 points, and the throw the pick came over me to go to the ward. Stuff like that is disheartening, you know what I mean? And you want to leave because of it. And as a pro, it's just, listen, it's not a glamorous sport, you know what I mean? Like, football's a glamorous sport, you know what I mean? You get to look the part and not get punched in the face. Getting punched in the face ain't nice, you know what I mean? It's not nice at all. So, you're training 2-3 times a day, you've strict on diet, you're strict on social life, it's hard, you know what I mean? You have to have the love of the sport itself. It's like, you really have to love the job you're doing to be in the job.
Yeah.
It's not good saying, oh, I'm a professional boxer and thinking it's this, that, and the other. I fucking ain't that.
No.
Yeah, and then you have people that obviously come up to you and trying to get stuff off you all the time and stuff like that as well. There's always the people there at the hands out as well.
Of course, but that's like anything, if anyone's doing well for themselves, it comes hand in hand,
isn't
definitely. Martin, as you were saying that before, former middleweight champion, said that when he beat Chavez Jr., he said he had 1,000 texts on his phone, and then when he lost to Cotto, no one texted him.
He said he had 3 texts. 2 was off his man, and 2 texts. When 2 was off his man, 1 was a private number or something like that. I've seen that before. That's just the way boxing is, you know what I mean? Like, you have that small circle, and you know who's there for you, and listen, and you get people jumping the bandwagon, which is no harm. Like, it's good to know where you stand, you know what I mean? Like, it's like anything else. Like, you meet people in life and you know where you stand with them. You know what you get out of them, you know what I mean? So you don't expect any more, like, you know what I mean? These, some people put a front on you, think they actually want to love you for you and who care about you. And some people, you know, listen, they're only supporting you because of this, that, and the other. But you know where you stand, you know what I mean? Which I prefer to know, you know what I mean?
Yeah. How's the weight cutting going for the fight?
Yeah, weight's coming down nicely. We have about a month left. It's on point, so you don't try to rush down the way too fast, so it's coming there slowly. Plenty of sex helps as well, you know what I mean? Plenty of sex, plenty of cardio. You know what I mean?
But to keep it down,
you know what I mean? All boxes don't say, but plenty of cardio, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Weight's come down nicely, we're on point, and listen, we will be there on the 18th, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
I don't struggle too bad in the way, so I'm pretty big for the weight, but pretty tall, but weight ain't too bad.
Mm-hmm. Like, 2 days before the fight, obviously that's mostly when you lose all the water. I mean, would you have to dehydrate a lot? Or?
No, some people do the water weight, I don't do it. I don't believe in it. I know a few other pros do, and you die after 4 or 5 rounds. It's a 12 round fight, we're ready for a 12 round fight to be in tip top shape and have great energy. So at the moment, I'm probably only 3 pounds out of the weight, you know what I mean? So it's little or nothing, you know what I mean? So I won't be taking much weight off at all, and I definitely won't be dehydrating myself.
Right. Because when you think about it, like, there is loads of fighters trying to get an advantage by trying being the bigger man at a smaller weight class, but the gas out because of the dehydration you're talking about. Like, would you say that's something that goes against a lot of fighters, like Kell Brook, obviously Conor McGregor only fought Mayweather? Do you think that's one thing that really goes against him? Like,
no, well, Kell Brook, it's not only his last fight he lost at his actual natural weight, you know what I mean? He is too big for it, but all the other fights he's won world titles at. I do think it does affect a lot of people, but you have to be realistic as well. Some people are huge for the weight and you can't make, and they're struggling, and the legs do go dead after a few rounds, but I think anyone who's smart knows where that limit is, you know what I mean? Like, at one stage we were talking about going down to featherweight, and then be realistic, would I make it? The thing was, would I die out towards later rounds? So that's what we ended up didn't do, and we stayed at super featherweight because I could have made it, but I make super featherweight comfortable. Also, I'm big enough to be lightweight or light welter if I put on a bit more muscle, so I probably will go up the weights instead of down them, you know what I mean? But I've no plans on dropping weight, you know what I mean? Dropping much weight.
Yeah.
Like, some people lose too much weight, and I think it's dreadful, you know what I mean? You're training to lose weight, you're not training to get fit. That's the difference, you know what I mean? And if you're trying to lose weight, that's where you're fucked.
Yeah, because your camp is just about making weight. That's all you're thinking about, will I make it, will I not? And then chunky, your purse goes out the window, and then if you don't make it, it's
of course, you're going to get fined, you know what I mean?
Yeah. Or like Gervonta Davis, who got stripped.
Stripped of the world title. Yeah. I still think he might stay a super featherweight.
Yeah, well, they were saying that he took the fight in short notice because Sean Porter pulled out of the card. So he took it, but apparently he was out and stuff.
Yeah, probably so, you know what I mean? Stuff, but, so. Like, I know he struggled with Liam Walsh, he struggled with Liam Walsh. I know he had to try three times that day to make the weight, but he made the weight. So he probably isn't actually too big for it, but I still think he's not that tall, so he might make super featherweight again.
Yeah.
Blue weight, he'd be pretty small for it, I think.
Yeah, that's a serious weight division. That's a serious division. Like, yeah. Like, you have Tevin Farmer fighting for his vacant belt now as well. Like, yeah. That'd be serious stuff. Yeah.
Some serious fights. It's good for boxing, you know what I mean? A lot of good profile, high profile fights are happening now, you know what I mean? So, which is good. You only had the Golovkin and Canelo fight, which I believe will happen again in a rematch. These are the fights what boxing needs, you know what I mean? Because of MMA are coming up, you know what I mean? They're coming up, and boxing needs, instead of, there's four legit world titles. So sometimes you have people ducking and diving each other, which I believe the best should fight each other.
Yeah. Like Terence Crawford's the last person to unify the welterweight division, light welterweight, in a long time, like unified champion. And then he had to vacate the IBF like a day later.
There's certain rules, like Joshua. With Tyson Fury. Tyson Fury got stripped of, I think it was two of his belts.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So it's way money talks, you know what I mean?
Yeah,
so it's the way you have to get away with doing you have manager challengers, and then you have one manager challenger on one side of the titles, and then on the other side of the titles. So it's hard to walk around, you know what I mean?
Yeah. It's very political, like, really political. Because he was stripped of the IBF because he wouldn't fight Glasgow straight away.
Yeah.
And Glasgow fought Martin for the title.
That's
serious, like.
And did you ever have any other aspirations, like, in the football world or anything like that?
Two left feet. Listen, everyone, I could be a footballer, for sure. Stand around and look pretty. I'm on this channel, plenty of footballers, subscribers going to be giving me stick out of it, but to me, I have a lot of people who play football, a lot of good friends who are play in England and all that, and who represent Ireland, who are high profile footballers, but it's different than boxing. Like, it's you get tackled, you're all around the floor and cry about it, you know what I mean? And probably get someone sent off, a yellow card or something, so it's different. But, of course, yeah, I would love to be a footballer, but be realistic of two left feet and can only go through someone instead of taking the ball around them, so it would never happen, but...
Would you still be a fan of, like, the national team?
Yeah,
like
of course, like anything else, just sport me on. Even rugby, like, I don't like rugby at all, but I still want Ireland to do well. Yeah. I'll watch the football, I probably will go to the Denmark home game, have tickets there, I'll probably go to it, but it's a week before the fight, so I probably will, I probably won't, but I'll be there supporting them anyway. And
how do you think it will go?
Listen, they're the lowest ranked team, weren't they, in the group they could have against.
Well, that we could have got,
yeah. Yeah, so, do you know what I mean?
Well, they do have a select number of players, and I do believe... We have a better team, whereas they might have some better players, such as Ericsson and the likes of them, Casper Schmeichel and a couple of players, but they're not a great chase compared to what we could have got.
I think we'll qualify, well, I hope to God they qualify. I still don't think we're very good at football, you know what I mean?
Yeah, I think the key would be if we can go to Copenhagen, get a result and bring it back to Dublin with something to play for.
Yeah.
And we need to get an away goal.
That's it, even a 2-1 loss. But listen, I'm sure they're playing for the win, and please God they get a win or a draw and take it home. But hopefully they fucking, listen, it lifts the whole country when they qualify, you know what I mean? That's what I find mad. Like, we have people who are world champions at boxing, and the impact's not the same, you know what I mean? It just hasn't caught on. I don't think it's been the same since Bernard Dunn, where we got kind of that kind of buzz around, especially Dublin anyway. We have Carl Frampton, who's only at the signing with MTK. Who that's on the undercard I'm boxing on, is he sells out stadiums up there, you know what I mean? That's where, but he's big up the north. It's the south, he's big, but he's not as big. Like, look what McGregor does. McGregor has the whole country a standstill, and that's what I believe football does. There's great money in it. There's great money in it as well. So I think they're overpaid, but as well, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
The cunts are definitely overpaid. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Like, well, especially the ones that talk for Man City. So we leave that for a different day.
I have a friend, Jack Bourne, actually. He's from, he's Wigan he's playing for now.
Yeah.
Is it Wigan he's playing for now? He gets a call up to the Irish squad now as well. So, like, the likes of them I know personally, I wish them all the best. And you never begrudge anyone making a few quid, you know what I mean? So, boys, like I said,
a lot of people are kind of hoping that Jack will come through now and progress or get game time for dropping down a level and obviously come back up then and maybe be.
Well, he was the captain of the city team of the academy, wasn't he? Yeah. So he has a lot of pedigree to go there, you know, exactly. There's a lot of hopes, so please God he does. But like I said, there's a few other young lads now as well who are doing the same thing as him. And listen, I'm not a big football, I support United, but I wouldn't be day in, day out fucking on him. Like, he's a heavy United fan, you know what I mean? But I don't go. I watch him sitting around ball and not mad at the football the way I used to be.
Yeah, but you still have support in that national team.
Of course, without a shadow of a doubt.
Yeah. Well, hopefully we'll get the result in Copenhagen. Well, thanks very much for coming on the show. Really appreciate it.
No problem.
Best of luck with the fight as well.
Thanks for having me.
Kieran as well from Heavy Bag Boxing. Thank you very much. Guys, if you want any other videos or to try get in with any other Irish people, boxers, MMA, fighters, anything like that, let us know in the comments. Don't forget to subscribe, don't forget to like, and don't forget to share. Thank you very much for watching Irish Football Fan TV. Have a great day.